All right. Welcome back to another episode of the Training Mac Podcast. It is your host, Oscar Daddy, Derek Poppy. Jamison Poppy, aka Mr. Seen the Simpatic, and just playing in a relationship, but I really don't. Ha! Another week, another episode, of course. We're back in this studio for the last time, for a little bit, I want to say, for a little bit. The reasons, I'm not going to really get into it, but we're here with some interesting people. One newbie, one regular. We'll start with the regular. Go ahead and introduce
yourself. Ladies first, bro.
Alright, you sure, man?
Yeah,
man. Nah, hit the AKs, nigga. All right, okay. Hit the AKs,
let's
nigga.
Let's get it. It's your boy, Matt, a.k.a. Easy Money, mm-hmm. a.k.a. Babyface Killer, yep. a.k.a. Mr. Boy Girl. Give her back in 3 to 5 business days. We in here. Shout out Bigger Dream. Shout out to Randy. Belongo, the streets, actually, you know what? Beside the blue bin and the green bin, there's a spot right there for her.
There you go.
There you go.
And then we also have...
Hey guys, what's up? It's Gigi, aka the Peruvian goddess.
My bad.
Yeah, where's my intro?
Welcome, Gabby.
Yes.
Guys, I'm not gonna lie to you. Today, when I was cleaning and shit, well, before I was cleaning, we got a bombshell. We got a bombshell that I've been expecting for quite some time now, seeing as I'm a OVO guy, I'm a Drake supporter, you know what I mean?
Oh,
we're gonna get to it. Right, okay. So I'm cleaning. I just scroll Twitter and I see, I get butterflies in my stomach. Pause. You know what I mean? Because I'm like, though, this is.
No, Diddy.
It's good. It's happening, right? So I click on, and of course, I hear the audio of the Drake diss, and I'm like, dog, it's happening, right? But then I get like a few seconds in, I'm like, nah, this is sounding not like, it's not sounding mastered, it's not sounding mixed. Like, of course, it's a leak, but I'm like, this could be an AI, right? But before we get too much into the AI or not, let's get into this song. Already the beat, I'm like, all right, he's taking us there. The dumpy side. Shout out, Drake. Look, I could never be nobody number one fan. Your first number one, I had to put it in your hand. All right. We're going to stop right there already.
That was disrespectful.
But did he lie? The first number one, he put it in your hands.
No, he's not.
Yeah.
He had to start that way, though.
Who is he talking to?
It's Kendrick. Yeah.
And?
Poetic Justice. And J. Cole?
No, and Rocky.
Yeah. Or Rocky, sorry. Yeah, because fucking problems. Yeah.
Exactly.
And that video keeps resurfacing.
No. That's not America for now. I'm out in Tokyo because I'm big in Japan. I'm the hit maker y'all depend on. Tough on record in my city, it was friend zone. You won't never take no chain off of us. How the fuck you been stepping with a size 7 minutes? Ooh, man. Shout out to all the niggas with small feet, but that's not me, baby. Listen, size 7. That's tough.
That's super tough.
That's tough. Calling yourself a big stepper, a small feet fan.
Damn.
That's true. It's hard to say at size 7.
You're like a medium. Like, come on, dog. Like, come on. With the bike, nigga, what's up? I know my picture on the wall when y'all cook up. Extortion, baby, open red, you been shook up. Stop, so you drop and give me 50 like some push-ups. Your last one brick, you really not on shit. They make excuses for you cause they hate to see me lit. Put your contract cause we gotta see the split. Hey, the way you doing splits, bitch, your pants might rip. Dog. The thing about Drake, he's going to shoot at you at your chest. Cause you know how like Kendrick left TDE, right?
Yeah.
And then he's now doing PG Lang, and that's under Interscope. So it's like a little like a almost like a Drake, Young Money. You know what I mean? Like mad splits within splits. So him saying this bar, I'm like, nah, you're rude. It's kind of dumb. I'm not gonna lie. Like in terms of like your split. What is it? You're stretching so much, you're gonna rip your pants. A little childish, but he's direct. Maroon 5 need a verse. You better make it witty. Then we need a verse for the Swifties. Top say drop. You better drop and give them 50. Piss squeak pipe down. You ain't in no big three. Scissor got you white down. Like your label boy, you in a scope right now. And you gon' feel the aftermath of what I write down. Bars. I'm at the top of the mountain, so you tight now. That was fucking tough. Just to have this talk with you, I had to hike down because I'm at the top of the hill. Stop playing with Drake, man. Between Mike and Mike now. What the fuck is this, a 20v1, nigga? What's a prince to a king? He a son, nigga. I get more love in the city that you from, nigga. Metro, shut your whole ass up and make some drums, nigga. Metro's like, damn, bro. Like, they're beefing with, like, shut your ass up and make drums. Like, come on. God, I'm the front runner. Y'all nigga manager was Chuz, little blunt runner. Clean the 6 and you boys ain't even come from it. And when you boys got rich, you had to run from it. Cash flow enable bread out here tricking. Shit we do for bitches, he doing for niggas. That's tough. Jet switch chains, wicked, wicked, wicked. Spinning like you trying to fuck, boy, you tripping. Drizzy chipping, that was probably got you bitches. Oh, that's kind of weird. What did you mean by that? Boy, don't make me at the chipping nail. Rolling loud stage, I was turned. That was slick as hell. Lucky that your dog, Lil Ben, doesn't kiss and tell. What is he talking about? Do you know?
On that bar?
Yeah, something happened at Rolling Loud. He said that was slick. He caught me slipping.
Oh, because he... I don't know if it's Rolling Loud, but I remember that Tyler concert where he got booed. Mm. I don't know. Do you remember that? Yeah, is he talking about that when he got caught slipping?
Nah.
Maybe not.
Yeah, I don't think it could be that. Like that's the thing. Like Drake is good with these undercover bars of like, yo, what is he...
Maybe it's between them and you just like... You
know? Yes, and he's the king of that shit. And that's why... That's how I knew immediately this song is not AI. Because first of all, I know Drake. You know niggas don't believe it like that. Like, so niggas call me a Drake hater for the longest time. But the thing is, I'm very critical of him because of how much I listen to. Mm-hmm. Right? So when this came out, I already knew, oh, this is like his bag. Just more than, it's bigger than the voice. It's bigger than the bars. It's the cadence. It's also the energy that's there. People are saying, oh, he's not very aggressive on here. But it's like, well, we've heard him. He sounds annoyed. He sounds annoyed that you're even making me do this. Like, this is not even the nuke that people are saying it's going to be. Like, it's really just him and his, like, oh, let me just write to these niggas real quick. But he's good at making these disses that are going to attack you and you only. Kanye was open about this. Who was another person that was open about this? They said, when Drake disses you...
It hits your soul.
Yes, and only you know he's dissing you.
Yeah. And that's dying slowly inside.
For real. And that's the worst part, because it's like, now you're out in the public saying, he's dissing me, and niggas look at you crazy. Oh, it's Joe Budden. Joe Budden was saying that too, and people were looking at him like, oh, Drake, Joe, you're delusional. Why would Drake be talking to you? But it's really the fact that it's like they had a relationship at one point, and he knows how to shoot at you, and he does this shit. And he's doing it all throughout this record. The Kendrick
Scorpio shit.
Do you know what?
That's what, you're Scorpio?
No, but a little bit. Wait, a little bit of Scorpio. Watch out. But they're going to execute in a timely manner.
Yes.
And they'll be your friend the whole time. Yeah. And it's like, what the fuck?
It's dangerous, man. It's a scary world to be in, like in Drake's world. I wouldn't want to be one of his friends.
He's like a data collector.
Exactly.
He collects data, and then as soon as you fuck him over, can I cuss?
Yeah, of course.
As soon as you fuck him over, he's like, all right, let me pull one out the books. Like, let me pull them from the file, you know?
That's exactly what he does. Friends like that are the scariest.
That's a good point.
I used to think only women move like that, but conversation for another time. Kisses, man, don't tell me about no switches. I'll be rocking every fucking chain I own next visit. All right. So that bar right there, I was privy to some information, all right? Exclusive. But Drake's shot, I mean Kendrick's shot to Drake on like that, where he said, for all you I can't say too much, but and so that bar was directed, like he pulled a Drake on Drake type shit. Where it's like, he said a bar that you know exactly what I'm talking about, but the masses are going to be like, oh, like this is just a sub.
Yeah, it's
going to
go over their head, yeah.
Yes. Oh, and shit. So that's where he brought it back. And yeah, you're going to get into it a little bit more. You'll see. I'll be with some bodyguards like Whitney. This right here. I'll be with some bodyguards like Whitney. Tough bar, right? Kendrick's wife's name is Whitney.
Oh, shit.
He pulled the Pusha T thing again. It's done, fam. It's raps. You get what I'm saying? Off limits now. Dog. It's gonna get ugly, bro. It's gonna get ugly. Try your little midget ass, better fucking. Damn, is that midget? This is hard, though. Niggas really got me out here talking like I'm 50. Niggas really got me out here rapping what I'm living. I might take the latest girl and cuff her like I'm Ricky. Can't believe he jumping in, this nigga turning 50. Dog. You know what we're talking about, right? Rick Ross.
Yeah.
Yeah. And this next bar is even ruder. Made it on a chart he got from Jersey. Worry about whatever going on with you and hey. No. Let's go back. Hold on. Nigga turning 50. Every song that
made it on a chart he got from Jersey. Ooh. It's kind of true though.
Every song of Rick Ross that made it to the charts was featuring Drake.
It's kind
of
true.
Wow.
Tough. Yeah. Tough. And then the next bar. Worry about whatever going on with you and Dog, do you know how evil that is? Worry about whatever's going on between you and... First of all, the blank rhymes with Christy, which is Christina Mack,
yeah,
his ex, whatever. But he also entered the fucking Rick Ross grunt. Did you hear it?
Yeah, yeah.
Dog, nah, this nigga is dog.
Thought I heard it. Every song that made it on the chart he got from Trizzy.
Worry about whatever going on with you and hey, nah.
I actually didn't keep that until you said it. That's,
you heard that? That's kind of crazy. So
this
funny.
Guy is evil, bro. Like, this is. Who would that be busting out the gritty? I know why you mad, nigga. I ain't even tripping. Mm. I ain't even rapping after this. So apparently, this is in reference to
what's his name? Dylan Brooks.
There you go.
Yeah, because he did the gritty and he's been talking shit.
To who?
Dylan Brooks.
Oh.
The ball player. He's the ball player from Saga. He's like the rudest player in the NBA.
Oh.
Easily.
Yeah. This for all the top dogs, drop and give me 50, drop. And that fucking song y'all got is not starting beef with us. This shit been brewing in a pot, now I'm here. Dog, direct. Nigga caught a top to see a top, wanna piece it up. Top, wanna piece it up. Top, wanna piece it up. Nah, pussy, now you on your own when you speaking up. You done roll deep to this, it's not fucking deep enough. Begging Costa not, where you not fucking beating us. Numbers wise, I'm out of here, you not fucking creeping up. Money wise, I'm out of here, you not fucking sleeping up. Money, show money, merch money, feed us. I'ma let you niggas work it out because I've seen enough. This ain't even everything I know, don't wake the demon up. That part is a confirmation of, like, yeah, this is not even the nuke. Like, this is even half the shit I know. Like, chill out. Like, come on, dog. I know, don't wake a demon up. Drop and give me 50, all you fuck niggas teaming up.
What? Mm. Teaming up, but all of y'all falling like some dominoes. Bros turning hoes, dog, like I ain't got enough of those. I can't see how far you niggas get to reaching now. This the closest thing you niggas getting to a feature now. Backpedal gang, cause a few of y'all are reaching out. Y'all drew the line, what the fuck we gotta speak about? Get your fucking head tapped, you niggas get to peeking out. Mm. You had a song for 4 years, drop that shit or shut your mouth. Drop that shit, Kenny.
Shut your mouth, nigga.
It's me twice in my big three, I had to leave you out.
That part.
Dumbass. Oh, that's so hard.
That part.
Yeah, that's not AI.
Me twice in my big three, I had to leave you out.
It's me twice in my big three, I had to leave you out.
Yo, that Cole bar was kind of like, because when you hear that Cole bar, it kind of sounds like J. Cole was like talking to him to like chill out. You know what I mean? And he's like, yo, fuck what Cole thinks, bro.
Yeah.
I don't give a fuck.
Yeah, exactly.
You know what I mean?
Oh, yeah. Overall thoughts of the song. We did a little breakdown bar by bar, of course, but what do you guys think about the song?
Pretty fire.
Yeah?
Yeah.
First time hearing it?
Yeah, my first time.
Okay.
I seen it on Instagram. I'm like, oh, this is AI. Like, no way. And everyone. So I didn't bother listening to it, but like, that doesn't sound like it's AI.
At all.
Uh-uh.
At all.
He took shots at the jugular. Like.
Yes.
Ouch.
Headshots.
No.
You know what? It's funny because last night I read something. I believe it's Charlamagne the God, but... Mm-hmm. It said something interesting. It's like, at the end of the day, it's the target's on Drake's back. He doesn't need any of these guys. No. At the end of the day, can he make a bigger hit than back to back? Like, that's the pressure's on that. You know what I mean? It's not about the other guys. It's about, can he outdo himself?
Yeah.
And I thought this was more personal, man.
Mm-hmm.
This back to back was maybe a bit more catchy, and it's like, you know, but this song is, in terms of shots and stuff, I think it's a better diss song.
Bro, Drake is Thanos, fam.
Yeah,
like, the name of this episode might be like Drake Knows. Because
so true.
Nah, man. Like, there's literally 20 of them attacking him. Everyone's popping up new ones every day, right? But like you said, I think it's an interesting point. He is kind of suffering from success because at this point he's gotten so big to where he can only go down. I don't know if we can compare this to back to back. I mean, I feel like people are going to fuck with this, of course, but it's a 4-minute song for one. I don't remember how long back to back was. I'm going to guess maybe around the 3-minute mark. Mm-hmm. And this one is more dense. It's he's attacking.
There's no hook.
There is, yeah. Drop him, give me 50.
Oh,
yeah.
That's
the hook.
Okay, it's not as catchy, I guess.
Exactly. It's not as catchy. And it's more dense, right? It's more compact. He's attacking people line by line. And then I feel like Charlamagne's also saying that because he had a little shot thrown at him in that song. But outside of that, no, I'm happy to hear him rap. We know for a fact this is not him saying like, oh, I sent some big shots out. He's saying like, deal with that.
Yo, Duke, I have a question for you.
Yeah.
We've heard, again, 2024 is off to a fucking bang.
Bro.
You've heard still a lot banging. Of diss songs. Mm-hmm. Who had the best diss?
Best is interesting, bro. Catchiest, diss, like that, easily. Because that beat is insane. Mm-hmm. The beat switch up, the Kendrick part, his energy on the track was just, bro, unmatched. So that's going to be up there. And then I think this one might be second, to be honest. Like, J. Cole shit, we're going to get to that.
How about you?
What was the question?
Like the diss is, like, between Kendrick's diss, J. Cole's diss, this one?
Definitely Drake's, yeah.
Mm. Okay.
Yeah, easily. All right, do you want to get into J. Cole?
Let's talk about it. We're on the topic. Let's
get into it.
Yeah, it's like I skipped the whole fucking timeline of everything because I didn't care about J. Cole. I just wanted to get straight to the Drake shit.
Yeah.
Cole, I can't remember the last time we podcast. We didn't cover that, eh? I don't think we did. So Cole came out and apologized on stage at Dreamville or whatever.
Dreamville Fest.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. This is like a couple days after putting out the diss track. Mm-hmm. Fam, defend your people, bro. Defend your guy, bro. This is your guy.
Yeah, he's my favorite artist.
Still?
Yeah.
Salute.
Yeah. Shout out Dirk Yo too. He's doing his thing.
Nah, fuck Dirk. I'm going to keep this short. I really just interrupted this episode to let you know to subscribe. Please do share this, give it a thumbs up, and subscribe. We're trying to get to 1,000, and please, we need your help to get there. So, subscribe, and back to the episode.
Yo, but I just feel like it's everything was a gimmick. Mm. Not in a bad way, per se, but it's just like the tape was called Might Delete Later.
Yeah.
Right? Mm. And it was supposed to be his rollout for his album Fall Off. Mm-hmm. He... Mm. Had a beautiful project, and the last song was a diss song to Kendrick, right? Yeah. And I just think that with that diss song, it didn't fit the rest of that amazing body of work. Mm. Everyone loved it. It's an EP that's gonna do better than a lot of artists' number one albums, right? Mm. So, again, it's called Might Delete Later.
Yeah.
And he dropped it. And then he had the Dreamville Fest, mm-hmm. and then he deleted the last track a week later. So it's like, I just feel like everything is set up, and mm-hmm. I feel like this whole beef is set up. Everyone's getting paid out of this.
A really good marketing play. If it's that.
If that's the case.
Because it's entertaining. And in my opinion, this is the most exciting thing in hip hop since the Control Verse.
Facts. Because I think they were saying, like, right now the females have hip hop with all the beefing happening up. So it's like, the guys had to come in, stir up the pot. And it's like, okay, is this for real, or is this like a marketing ploy?
Yeah.
Strategic one, like, you know?
Yeah. Honestly, before this Drake record, I think the women were winning in terms of the beefs. Like,
you got guys in their car doing Sexy Red song, you know?
Yo, like, come, bro. The girls were fucking. I lost track of everyone beefing.
Yeah.
Glorilla is involved in that. Yeah. The City Girls are beefing amongst themselves.
Yeah, it's a hot mess right now.
The Cardi's beefing. Who's she beefing with?
Everyone.
Nicki, same thing. Yeah. Nicki and Meg, like all that shit was going on. And I feel like the most recent one.
Your boy Quavo?
Bro.
Oh, that one.
Bro, that's again more beef. More beef again. Hold on to that. I want to get back to it. But I did want to ask you, is there such thing as being too mature? Like, in terms of the J. Cole situation, right? Like, he put this track out, felt like he was pressured to put it out, and then he kind of recanted a statement, right? Saying, hey, I went to bed and I couldn't sleep, and I was hearing, shit, like, come on. Like, you know, and he's like, okay, I have to leave this. You know, Kendrick is a great artist, blah, blah. Making the crowd cheer for that shit is disgusting, fam. That shit was nasty work. Niggas saying, who here thinks Kendrick's a good artist?
It's some beta shit, for real.
Bro, like, yo.
Fam, but go on. No, I understand it. Like, J. Cole's, like, on a higher learning, like, a higher vibrational. So, it fits with him to do that. You know what I mean?
So, he a bitch.
I don't know if that's a
bitch. We got him.
I feel like I listen to the song and, like, he's taking shots. I feel like his conscious. But, like, then again, is it a marketing thing? Mm. Like, if it's not a marketing thing, I feel like his consciousness doesn't sit well, like he said, because he's taking, like, shots at, maybe he knows how powerful words are, and he doesn't really want his brother to like go through all that shit. You know what I mean?
That's a good angle. That's a good angle. Yeah. Matt, fam, how did you feel when this thing was on stage? Your favorite artist, right? Your guy.
Yeah.
Saying, I'm a bitch.
Yo, I'm gonna be real. Like, I was definitely disappointed because, you know, even if you change how you feel about it, like, you know, we want to see you stand on it. You know, you could deal with it behind closed doors, but like stand on like what you released to the public. And
yeah,
I was a little bit disappointed in that, but in my opinion, I think it says something bigger about society. Mm-hmm. That
fuck society, nigga. We want violence, bro. This is your job, man.
Y'all do want violence. I'm about to say.
This is your
Cole
job,
is too
bro.
Safe. Cole is a safe artist. I've seen a meme on Instagram. It's like, Cole is for people who take the bus to work. And you know what? I'm like, wait, when I used to take the bus, I did
it. Slaps. Slaps on the bus.
I love it. You know, that's I love so Cole funny. And I love his music, but it's like, I feel like maybe he needs to create his own lane, like mm-hmm. like that, because he's like a more maturing artist, yeah, and like yeah. he doesn't really fit like the rap demographic with his like attitude. Mm-hmm. I don't know.
No, you're not wrong.
You know, it's interesting. In my opinion, like if we're talking about, okay, you guys could talk about records, you could talk about everything, but pound for pound in terms of like rapping,
he's good.
He's the best rapper.
He's amazing.
Pound for pound is crazy.
Yeah, he's amazing.
Pound for pound, bro.
Hey, yo.
Pound for pound.
He's doubling down on that shit too. It's crazy.
He's amazing.
Yeah, so like I just think that at the end of the day, it's like part of rap is competitive and part of rap is you got to do this type of shit. Mm-hmm. And
maybe he wanted to show that he's not just all love and light, you know?
It's not him though. He can he has bars. Yeah, he can bar up, but it's not him to go at someone like this. And again, staying true to character, I don't know, I don't like the move personally, mm-hmm. but I just think, again, someone is actually mature and saying, like, you know what? I actually made a mistake. No matter how much you guys fuck with this shit, I made a mistake, and people aren't willing to accept that.
Yeah.
People, you saw Maul. What did you think of Maul's reaction? You love that,
I loved it because I'm like...
you. Maul was you. He was your spirit animal. <little bit. laughs>
Maul took it a bit far because, I mean, no, he's right, because he also, in his mind, he knows it's not going to get to guns. It's not going to get to violence. Like, Kendrick versus Cole is not going to end up in a shootout. Let's be honest. They're just going to be barring each other out.
Yeah.
So for him to remove himself from this situation is just so strange to me and to everyone else, right? Especially the fact that he's an athlete.
But isn't it strange to you also how Future had Kendrick on the first album and then J. Cole on the second album?
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Isn't everyone just getting paid off?
Wow.
Yo, honestly, we don't trust him.
We still don't trust you.
Yeah, still don't trust him, bro. Well, that's that on that. Let's do Chris Brown and Quavo. This is the newest beef so far, right? This started at a fashion show. Oh, no, it started before the fashion show.
At a ball game, no? They were next to each other?
Yeah, that's the fashion show I'm referring
to. Oh, that's the fashion show,
so they're
okay.
sitting in the fashion show, and they're like, they weren't really fucking with each other. But all this was over Karrueche.
Who did their seating?
It's always over a girl.
A messy intern. They will,
yes. yeah. Yes. They'll do that on purpose.
Definitely a messy intern. But essentially, they're beefing over Karrueche, right? Mm. Which is confirmed because who put out the song first? It was Chris Brown.
Mm-hmm.
Chris Brown put out Deluxe for 11-11. And then on that song, he had a bar. I'm not going to play it because it's fine. And he had a song. Basically, the bar was referencing Quavo. You know, is a corny bar about tequila. See, we don't really fuck with this. Are we fucking 1942? Not Jose Quavo. I'm like, ooh. You know, like, whatever. And then what I did like, though, is the fact that Quavo came, I think it was the next day. Or within a few hours or some shit. Maybe the next day.
It was like, yeah.
Yeah, like almost.
Next day, pretty much.
Yeah, and then had a whole track about it.
Yeah, it was nice to see. Honestly, I don't think Quavo is like that competitive of a rapper. I think he's more like melodic. That's mm-hmm. what he's known for.
Mm-hmm.
It was good to see him bar up. Like, it's like, it was kind of like, for me as a fan, it was just a reminder, like, you know what? Like, he's still got bars.
Yeah. No, for sure. And I don't think, I mean, this beef might actually get violent. And I don't want it to, because, like, nigga, just keep it the music. But even then, do I want to hear more Quavo
dance
music?
Dance it out.
Exactly. Yeah, Quavo can dance, can he?
I think
or is that Offset?
That's Offset. Offset's a dancer.
Offset's
oh,
a
yeah.
Dancer.
He's got the moves. Huh?
Well, Offset can sub in for Quavo.
He what? Take Michael Jackson. Offset.
All right, yeah.
No, on stage, he has choreography.
No, he's actually like...
He's not like Michael Jackson, bro. All right, I'm about to do this with you, man. Yo, this thing is crazy, bro.
Shut up, Seth, bro.
No, this guy's wild. I'm not even entertained. This is crazy.
Real talk, bro. Backup dancers, your outfit changes.
He's not Michael Jackson. All right, man.
Was a backup dancer?
He has backup dancers, choreography. They're walking up and down the stairs.
He's just choreography?
With this nigga, bro. Oh, my God.
Say word. Nah, listen.
Okay, speaking of crazy niggas. And this guy here. He came out with the song. Now, he played a snippet of this song a few weeks ago. And then I'm like, this is a hit. This is a hit. The chorus is crazy, but it's a hit.
If I was a bad bitch, I wanna fuck me too.
Matt's face. This part's crazy.
To me.
It's bad. This is fire. This is fire, dog. Now, let's do a breakdown of this song, all right? If I was a bad bitch, I'd want fuck me too. I'd want to suck me too. Is it pause? If it's to yourself?
I feel like he's just a young artist and he's really feeling himself. It's not
a pause, it's a stop. Just stop recording.
I actually got to meet him. I saw that. We did his grills in the club when he came down to Toronto. And like... He's a baby. He's like 21. I'm like, oh my gosh. And he travels with his family. Yeah. And like, I just feel like he's reached so much, like, what's it called? Like so much
fame, success,
fame and success so early and so quickly. And plus, all right, I'm going to come in with my horoscopes. He's also Scorpio. You know how they get, they freaky.
Yeah.
So they freaky, like freaky. You know, they want to hear all your freak stories. And I just feel like he's really like, loving himself, and he needed to put out a song so that he can play it when he's with other bitches around. So they're like, oh yeah, I should do that, maybe.
He's a freaky youth, is what you're saying, basically.
Yeah, he's a freaky youth. Like, you see that video with Suki Hana and Sexy Red where they're both on the all floor fours, or was it a video shoot? I'm not sure what it was. And he's dog walking them. Like, he's getting it in. Wow. Like,
NLE. But nah, honestly, the song is fire, dog.
It is. I like it.
It's you know what I mean? It's catchy. You're not fucking with it at all?
Nah, it's just like, listen, I think NLE is like talented. I think he can rap.
Mm-hmm.
I'm a bit older, so like I don't necessarily resonate with that, like everything he does.
Yeah.
But again, I can respect like when he makes good music. I just didn't connect with that one.
Mm. Interesting. Nah, I'm excited to hear this in the clubs.
No, I like that song. That's gonna be when everyone needs to go home. Exactly. Sorry, all right, let's play the song where everyone needs to leave.
Yeah.
Be like, what the fuck is this fire shit?
You unfortunately won't be able to hear that apartment 200 for a minute because it's shut down for renovations right now, bro.
Oh no.
Yeah, like apartment 200, bro.
That's your spot.
Has my heart, dog. I've been going there since 2016, bro.
No.
You know what I mean? That's kind of
unwashed. What are you going to do now then?
But that's okay. Bro, that but that 10-year mark, it'll be nice, renovated, newly improved for you.
Oh.
Yeah. At first when they posted about it, I thought it was going to be shut down forever.
Oh.
And I'm like, nah. Like my heart was hurting. I'm like, no. Like I need to do a last, like, nah, I need to take time off work. Go there. You know what I mean? Get twisted, you know, for the last time. Because that's probably just, nah, it's a staple in the city.
Do you think it's going to change the vibe of the club?
If it gets renovated?
Yeah.
I don't know, we'll see. If they make it more into a club, I'm like, ah, that's gross. I'm done. But the thing I liked about Apartment 200 is that it never really felt like you're at a club. Because I don't like clubs. You know what I mean? It's like a bar.
Yeah, it's just a house party.
Lounge,
exactly. Yeah. Like, you know, that's the vibe. So if they change it and the vibe is still there, then it's good. If it's not, then it's time to hang it up. You know, I'm going to be home. I'm be a homebody. My true homebody. You know? But, okay. Now, I want to talk about this guy, Gerard Carmichael. You guys familiar with him?
I don't know who he is, but I seen the whole controversy around it
With Tyler.
Yeah.
Okay. So the show on HBO, there's two episodes out right now. The next one's gonna come out tomorrow. Fam, I watched this show the first. Did you watch it yet? No. I watched the show the first episode, right? And this nigga, bro, he's just doing a whole lot, man. Like. Inviting guys from Grindr over, like dealing with some own thing, like some things and stuff in his family with like being gay and his mom not accepting him, and then you know, so it's really just sometimes you kind of feel bad for him.
So it's a reality show based off of just him and what he's going through.
It's literally a reality show about reality, his reality.
His
it's
reality. Really
just
like
they're
okay.
Just filming him in his day to day.
Okay.
Right, because he's like a comic. He's just successful and stuff, so he does stuff right, mm-hmm. And the camera just kind of follows him around. But yeah, there's just a lot of like.
I have a question for you.
It was embarrassing.
As a straight man, like, how do you feel like when you see, like, because it's a lot of shows like Euphoria.
Trying to catch me, though. Yeah.
A lot of shows like this, right? You see a lot of like gay scenes and things of that nature. Like, does it bother you while you're watching? Is it okay? Like, how do you feel?
You trying to get me canceled? No. In all actuality, I feel like it's one of those like just don't get too intimate. It's like okay. But I feel like that's applicable to almost both.
Yeah, because it's like it's a double standard, right? Because it's like for straight people, they go.
Yeah, but there's even some straight people scenes that it's like, all right, this is a lot. Yeah. Like, you guys are doing too much. Like, I don't want to be seeing all this. It's just strangely too familiar. It's strangely too intimate, you know? But then when it comes to the gay stuff, it's like, all right, nigga, smooch and leave, nigga. Like, you know, sometimes they do a lot. And it feels like there's, like, they're definitely trying to say, look, look, ta-da, in your face, take that. And it's like, you're doing a lot. Just chill out. You know what I mean? But that's maybe that's just the way I'm taking it because I'm straight. But maybe the gay niggas are watching it like, oh, it's lit. But I'm just seeing it like, ah, it's a lot. Like, in this show, there's, I'm not going to lie, there's some scenes I have to skip. Because I'm like, nigga was sucking toes. Like, you know what I mean? Strange, intimate stuff like that where it's like, ah, like, I feel, I'm looking around like, yo.
You feel uncomfortable. You feel like you're in the room with them.
Yeah, y'all don't know about all that, but. Pause. That's some diddy shit.
Yeah, yeah. You know what I mean? It just, it makes you feel uncomfortable. It's like, okay, this is hella intimate.
Exactly. Yeah. It feels like I'm not supposed to be seeing this.
Yeah.
You know? And that's kind of what it was. But back to the show, there's just a lot going on. First episode with the whole Tyler situation was interesting.
That was embarrassing.
To say the least.
To say the least.
To say the least. So,
that's so sad.
Yeah, he said, he told Tyler he likes him. Tyler kind of just ducked at him. He said he's a stupid bitch, laughed at him, whatever, mm-hmm. being Tyler. And then never brought it up again. And so Gerard brought him back to the crib, said, let's talk about it. We need to talk about it. Which is so insane to me. You know what I mean? It's like, no answer is also an answer to. Deal with that. What else do you want from him? Like, isn't that kind of crazy?
Some people like to be beaten down.
I know. That's some freaky shit. You know what I mean? Like, that's how, like, yeah. Like, why do you want that, though?
He's young. I don't know. Young and dumb.
I guess.
When you're young, you just, you see a red flag and you're like, yep, that's where I need to go.
Yeah, no, I never. You had that?
What?
Attracted to red flags?
Yeah.
Damn. Still?
No.
Okay.
No. As soon as I see a red flag, I'm like, hell no, bye.
Got you.
What was there a red flag that you were attracted to when you were younger that you're no longer attracted to?
That's a very spontaneous question.
We got her.
I know. I think the fast life was when I was growing up. I think it's because it was marketed a lot to us growing up through, like, the media and just, like, the music. And, like, that just leads to bullshit. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. I'm past that. So, like, now it's like when people try to holler at me and they're on that level, it's just like, I am attracted to stability.
Yeah,
stability is nice. And peace, and not having to look behind my back.
Duke's attracted to peace too.
Peace, stability, and safety.
Peace,
safety. I love safety.
I want peace in 2024, right?
That's impossible. That's not happening in 2024. 2024 is an 8-year. It's not gonna happen. It's karmic. Whatever you do is coming right back to suck.
Really?
Yeah.
Damn.
Why do you think all the fucking shit's happening since the year started, literally? Right. And it hasn't stopped. It's going to continue all year.
Shit. Well, I mean, my karma's good, I feel like. I don't do it.
It's just like whatever you push out, you're getting back in. So depends on you. Yeah.
Deep.
Yeah, sorry.
That's cool.
But I wanted to ask you guys, so like the Gerard Carmichael situation, right? Have you had that happen or even been in that situation where you told someone you like them? They were, like, kind of ducking it, and you pressed the issue. Or have you had the opposite? Where the person kind of told you they like you, and you're kind of, like, chill. And they want you to kind of stab them in the heart.
Yeah.
You've had that happen?
I've had both. I'd say, like, when I was younger, I would express myself, and it's like, you know, you get, like, the no answer, which is the rejection, and you don't really understand. So that's what I was saying. Like, he's probably young. He doesn't get it. The no answer means like he's not interested. Mm-hmm. And I feel like now I'm dodging people because I don't want to hurt their feelings.
That's deep.
I'm not really good with my words. Like, I'm very straight shooter, so I'm like, I'm not trying to hurt people. So until I figure out the proper wording, I'm gonna handle it like Tyler.
Order food and be like, yo, just come in the room.
That's good. So you're going, what are you doing tonight? You going home? Okay.
That's tough, man. Matt, what about you?
I think I don't like getting rejected.
Wait.
We all don't.
On that note, I'm like really good at feeling out. Like, I don't express that I like someone unless I get signals. Like, I'm like paying attention. Like,
unless you're sure it's like 80% win.
Yeah. Like, I'm really like, I want to make sure if I'm shooting my shot, that motherfucker better go in, you know?
Yeah.
That's kind of how I see it. I try to avoid getting rejection. It happens, but I just, it's not my game. I'm not the type of guy who, like, will say something slick to a girl and for sure get rejected and just move on to the next girl. Like, I'm kind of
Bitch!
I don't move like that. But, Yeah, in terms of the other way, yeah I feel bad. I feel like, unfortunately, I really love the chase, and once I got it, I my feelings changed. So.
Oh my god, yeah. You got fuckboy.
Toxico, bro. Yeah. You call me toxic, bro. That's you, dog.
Yeah, I'll take it this time. I'll take it for this episode. Episode 28, my toxicity.
Ladies, red flag.
Yeah, nah, that's madness. But yo, episode 2 was even crazier because now he has a boyfriend, right?
So who has a boyfriend?
Gerard Carmichael.
Okay.
So he has a boyfriend now. They're working on this monogamy thing. Gerard cheats, right? So he calls, like, because his boyfriend's, like, long distance, right? So when he's there, they're all, like, coupley, lovey-dovey. He goes away. He gets on the apps, calls somebody over.
I've seen that.
And he's, like, cheating on the show, right? And
that's,
I'm like,
bro,
this is great. Multiple times. Like, he cheated once, told them, like, oh, fuck, okay, we're going to work on it. Does it again, all right? And now they go to, like, couples counseling. Right, and now they're in front of the couple, whatever. She's like, how are things going? Like, I think things are going well. Like, you know, she's like, do you have anything you have to tell him? Like, nah, like, I'm really liking monogamy. Like, I don't know, at this point, like, and he's laughing. Right? Like, I don't know, I feel like I have, like, a joke, but I'm not going to say it. But it's like, where would I find the time to cheat, you know?
Yeah.
And I'm watching this, and I'm fucking dying. Because I'm like, this nigga is sick, bro. He's a sick nigga. And the cameraman zoomed into his face, too.
Oh, no.
And so that's how, like, the boyfriend kind of peeped. He's like, wait, something's going on here. Mm-hmm. You know, and then they kind of talked about it later, and I'm like, this is just a mess. Like, Gerard is a mess. He thinks he's like a sex addict, which he is, because he has over 1,000 bodies. And he's like, I feel like I'm downplaying it. And I'm like, yo,
that's disgusting.
1,000 bodies, and he hasn't caught anything is crazy.
That's God bless him. Maybe because we don't know.
Yeah, no. But honestly, the episode is just wild. A lot of craziness happening there. So I feel you guys should definitely watch it and tune in.
Can you forgive someone who cheats? Like, can you, like, or are they gonna just repeat it if you? If you decide to work through it,
I feel like in a relationship you get like one free cheat card.
Not for me.
No, but I'm saying, like, okay, for me, like, if there's a guy, because guys just like cheat, right? So I'm gonna give you one, and then I'm gonna observe you, and if I see that you're continuing to do what you're doing, I'm gonna secure my bag, and then I'm gonna say bye.
That's a good approach, honestly.
Yeah. I'm not going to discuss it again. I'm not going to be like, hey, why are you still cheating on me?
Yo, you know why I fuck, like, with that? Because
it's like, deuces, bye. Like, I can, why would I settle for one guy when I can have three guys? One giving me dinner, one giving me money. Like, you know what I mean? I'm not sleeping with all of them. I'm just saying, like, I can, you know, just string them along.
That's true.
You know? Jeez. I can get more being single than being with one. So it's like, okay, you want to do that? Cool.
It's an evil world we live in.
I always think,
you know,
about
what
that.
But you know, this is how I think now.
Yeah.
As I'm older, but when I was younger, I've never cheated, believe it, like, on my like family, I swear to God, I've never cheated, and I've been cheated on, so it's like, okay, you know what, this world is not fair. Mm. Why am I paying fair? Mm. I'm a grown woman, so I can do what I want.
What do you think?
Now I want to hear what you think first.
Okay, first of all, I fuck with her answer because I just feel like that's guy's nature. Guys are very visual creatures.
Yeah.
So it's like, I feel like your one pass is like, you know, understanding of that.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Are you in a relationship right now?
No.
Okay.
I don't. Yo, honestly, deep inside of me, just like loving humans. Like, I want to say I would, but I guess that's a super sensitive spot for me, and I would just, I don't know if I could. It's tough.
I feel like it's hard.
I think it's like, it depends how you feel about that girl too. Like, how long have you been with her, right?
Yeah.
True.
Is it worth, like, seeing past? If it's been like you know, 2-3 months.
If she's cheating on you, it's not worth it.
Exactly. You know, odds are, if it's early relationship, you're not gonna stay.
And you take her back, she's gonna think you're a punk.
I can't get over it, so I'm not gonna do it. Like, I recently saw this news article. No, I think I heard somebody talk about it. Basically, this guy, this couple, like, they're like 89 and 90.
Oh my God, I've seen that
right?
one.
And what happened is he found some love letters in his wife's shit, whatever, and then found out, like, she cheated, like, years ago while they were together. He left her. He divorced her.
Can you imagine that? Divorce at their big age.
That would be me.
What?
That's what I'm saying. Like, that would be me. It's like, nah.
So
like,
you're going to be divorced, living in the same house, sleeping in different rooms?
Yo, get out of the house. you're about to kick the fucking bucket anyway. Like, you're done. Like,
that's
nah, get
crazy.
Out of here. That's crazy. Like, yo, you cheated on me that many years ago, and you kept the letters?
Maybe she's still cheating.
Yo, that's
kind of
cheating at 89?
Because seniors be the freakiest, okay? Damn. The level of sexually transmitted diseases that happen at in
homes. You're right. Yeah, yeah.
In
yeah.
homes, they get it in. They take their dentures out and they get it in.
Yo, man, that's would you crazy. Pop
a old lady?
No.
For some money?
No.
Are you sure? He's like, he's out about it. He's like, yeah, no.
She's gotta be like minimum a cougar. If she's not a cougar, I can't go to.
How about if it was like $10,000 on the table? Just like, and it's like, it'd only be like 3 minutes.
Honestly, depends how down bad I am.
That's an honest answer.
That's a quick 10 back for 3 minutes, fam.
I know.
I'm giving Gam the work.
Close your
fam.
Eyes.
You're bugging.
Yo, on this topic, I had a question in mind I really want to know from both of you.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm scared.
Who, I have a theory that married men are hornier than single men.
How do you know that, fam?
Do you guys agree or disagree?
Yes. I think like humans just like want what they can't get.
Generally. When I talk to married men,
yeah.
and again, my age group, they're like newly married and shit, and they might not have a kid or they just had a kid, okay. something like that. I just find they're horny as fuck.
Did they get women before they got married? That's what I'm saying. That's usually the kid. I feel like it's like...
True. That's true, actually. I agree with that.
It's like if they didn't have that, then they're like itching. They're like, I agree with that. Out there. But it's I like, agree listen, with that. The reality is, if you were single, you would be the same you were before. Like, you wouldn't be Mr. Bitches all of a sudden. You'd be the same nigga you were before.
Yeah.
So it's like, it's just this fallacy of like, oh, I have access to all these women. Yo, if I was single, fam, yo, it'd be different.
Yeah. So what's your answer?
Huh? What's the question, fam?
Are married men hornier than single men?
Yeah, I think it would depend like who the person was before, you know?
But on average, from like what you see and what you observe in your life?
From what I see in my personal life, I wouldn't say so, but I've definitely heard stories. So I think I would say maybe yes. Like I've heard stories of just the shit that married niggas doing, like, oh, that's just some weird horny nigga shit. Like, what is wrong with you? Yeah. Like, relax, you know? Like, what's why are you moving like
for
this?
Real,
like,
for real.
They just want to always peek into you, like, yo, how was it? Yo. Like, they ask you some weird questions.
Yo,
like,
talk your shit right now.
What color is the nipples? I'm like, yo, what? Like,
I think you know why that happens because, like, in relationships, when you're married, the woman generally settles down. She gets comfortable. Mm. She just stops doing her hair. She stops being spontaneous, pretty.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? She just gets comfortable. And like humans, we want that like stimulation, that like up and down.
Something exciting.
Yeah,
thrilling.
Something exciting, thrilling. So if you can maintain that in your relationship, then I feel like it'll be a lot better. I don't know if it's going to help the cheating or not, but it's just going to kind of like curve that maybe a little bit.
Yeah.
Okay. Wait, she has to answer. I need to know your answer.
What?
Who's hornier, single men or married men?
I think married men. Because married men feel like they can't, because they're married, like they can't get like, you know, girls like that. Like they have to be faithful to their wife. So they're like, okay, you know what? She's gone for the week in Mexico. I'm going to call a couple of bitches over and let me do that.
Yeah. That's tough.
I don't know. I see it happen a lot.
Nah, for me, like when I'm locked in, I'm locked in. And then when I'm single, I'm single. Like,
because you're not the majority of men, but the majority of men, I feel like that's what it is. Mm-hmm. Like, why do people divorce? Infidelity? Is that a high number?
It's a lot of things. And it's also like, it goes back to what you were saying earlier about like, if you get cheated on once, it's like, yo, that's your one and done. I mean, sorry, you're going to give him another chance, but you're not going to bring it up again. That is the scariest thing to me.
That's my Scorpio side.
Yeah, but that's the not bring up shit. It's like, nah, like you get home, your bags are packed. Oh, what's going on? It's
and you like, can sleep off. You're like, oh, I was out with my boys. Okay, cool. Yeah. Ooh, I'm like, so good. Once I'm not jealous, like, ooh,
this fam,
red flag, baby.
That is the scariest point, I feel like, when women turn into like HR. We're like, we've discussed your progress. You're not going anywhere.
That's so mean.
You're being terminated.
Like, oh, okay, that's great.
It's that's crazy. Fucking terrifying.
Shout out HR.
HR for real, bro. But still in relationships, I wanted to ask you this. I saw this example or this story from Andrew Tate, which is a terrible example, but listen to it.
No, I like Andrew.
Oh, you like Andrew?
Yeah, I like Andrew.
Okay. So he was talking about he would never let his girl drive his, was it a Bentley or whatever? He's like, I'll let my brother drive it because I know that if he crashes it, he's going to pay me back. He's going to, like, you know, figure it out to fix it. Whereas for the girlfriend, she's going to be like, oh, my God, babe, I'm so sorry. And then that's going to be it.
Mm-hmm.
Like, she's not going to work towards, like, you know, helping you fix it or even, like, saying, like, oh, I'm going to take responsibility for that.
And he probably doesn't want to put the pressure on her either because, you know, she can't handle it.
Exactly. So he's saying, like, he says that women don't have that sense of responsibility that they need to fix it in relationships. Do you think that's true?
To fix what?
To fix whatever mess you made. Like, in an example like that, like if you fuck up big time.
I think on a general level, yes. I'm a team player, so I like to get my elbows greased up and stuff. But I think on a general level, because he's a high profile guy with a lot of money, he's going to meet a lot of women who like are a little bit, you know, bimbos. You know what I mean? Like, that's what it is. And you can't really, like, they don't know how to cook. I'm generalizing, you know what I mean? But like, not super intelligent women who are capable in that sense. And like, maybe that's not like sexually appealing to him either. You know what I mean? So, if I were him, I would give my brother the car too.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Interesting. Matt, your thoughts?
I think it's like, it comes with response. It's the same thing as your kid though, right? It's the same, like, your wife or your girl, you're going to treat as your kid, right? You know your kid's not going to take responsibility for it.
What do you mean by that?
you know, just in the sense where it's like, you know that this, like, depending on what this person does and stuff, if you're saying that they depend on you and rely on you for finances,
okay,
so does your kid, right? So you're going to treat them in a similar way.
Interesting. I feel like some women listen to this and be like, yo, fuck this nigga, bro. So for them, we got it. We got it. We fucking got it.
Headshot.
Now, I have a question for you too, Matt. So for this is a scenario that the homie asked me. He's like, yo, let's say you're out with some friends at a bar or whatever, right? Mm. You're having a good time. Everyone's drunk, having a good time. You see your one homie talking to shorties, and he's showing her his bank account.
Oh, my God.
Like, his balance and shit, whatever. What do you do in that moment?
Depends. If that's the same motherfucker owes me money, we gonna talk after. No, I'm kidding. But you know what's funny? I see that a lot on TikTok, where I'm like that famous podcast. I don't know their name, but you know. Some girls are like that. On the first date, they want to see your bank account to know you're like you're actually a real deal thing, and that's actually a controversy. So, listen,
it's wild.
I don't agree with it, but at the same time, I actually understand that. You know, if you're really into this girl, I know it's crazy you're in a club and stuff, but if you're really into this girl and things are going, and that's kind of what's gonna get you to first base or second base, do what you gotta do, bro.
No, nigga.
Log into TD, RBC, BMO. Nah. Do what you gotta do, bro.
Oh my gosh.
Can never let that fly, bro. That is not. If a nigga in my crew did that shit, first of all, I'd approach him like, yo.
What if he has like 10 figures as his balance and he's just like fucking flexing it?
Bro, more reason not to do that shit. That is so dangerous. Goofball, corny shit. Nah, nigga, don't do that.
That's fair. That's fair.
You're leading with money. Oh,
from that perspective,
get away from me. You know what I mean?
You can get set up in a city like Toronto.
Yeah, that too. But just like, nah, man.
Bare setup things.
My homie's doing that and he's drunk and he's like arguing with me about it. I'm like, all right, you got it, bro. But. Nah.
You're gonna approach him then and there.
Yes, immediately. Like, you know what I
mean? Yo, you know what? No, you're a good friend. I fuck with that.
I would have snatched their phone.
That's nasty work, bro. I'll be like, talking about something. Chill out, chill out.
I'll approach him after the fact, not in the middle of it.
Because you don't love your homies, bro. Huh? That's no homie of mine is gonna have no game, fam. No.
If that's his game, his account's gonna get wiped.
We
like,
can talk about it after, though. Not in the middle.
It'll be too
late. I got
late.
Fam. I have to traumatize you. The way you traumatized me by seeing this, I'm gonna traumatize you too because. I had no idea I was dealing with a nigga like this. You know what I mean? Like, nah.
I wouldn't have brought you out if I fucking knew.
Exactly. I'm not driving the same car as this nigga, bro. Like, exactly. Like, nah.
Get your own table. Get your own booth.
Exactly. I can't even look at you, bro. Like, nah. This is that's crazy, man.
I'm gonna wait till after. Like, I'm not gonna talk block. Come on, bro.
He's taking a more peaceful approach. You're more chaotic. Gemini. Sagittarius. But like, give me that.
I think they're both right. You guys are both right. It's just different approaches.
Yeah. Nah. Definitely not doing that shit. Let's get to music. So, my guy, Party Next Door, is dropping soon. And he dropped a few singles so far. This latest one, it's been real nice.
So good.
Yeah.
Real nice. And what I love is that every single one of these singles has been party in his bag. It's been party bag, you know what I mean? So, it's like you already know what to expect. I'm really excited for this album. This cover's mad.
But yeah, the cover is what I love it.
I love it too.
I can't put it on YouTube. I'm not. This is crazy.
It's good. But it's a nice cover.
It is.
Good marketing.
Hey, y'all gonna make me lose my mind. Couldn't make me choose it. It depended on my life. Once has Spanish and once has white. Ooh, and my tattoo is on her.
Bro, I predicted this, but I said when I saw you was thick again, I'm like, yo, bro, the vocal's gonna be crazy. The album's gonna be nuts. Like, nah.
Bro. Bro. Different.
I'm really excited for this. It's I'm good, a yeah. big, big Party fan, so that was fire. Bryson Tiller's album as well. I never discussed it on here.
Bro, J. Cole shut up, like, ruined his release.
Look, yeah. Still. Mm-hmm. Him, Big Sean, all that shit. Yeah. Yeah. What did you guys think about the album? Did you hear it?
Yeah, I heard it. I like it.
What's your favorite song on there?
I'm not really good with the words, the names. I have to hear it.
We'll play this one.
Calypso was hard.
Calypso is very tough. I like that one a lot. He's staring at this is another one I stood out to me too. This yeah. little play on words.
Oh, yeah, right? I love this song. The way they were playing with these words like that, yeah. incredible.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, this one.
It's such a good song. He asked if he could grab all of my absolutely. Woo! I'm in no opposition, so I'm gonna sit on that decision. Five. So creative.
Yeah, really is. Super.
At first, I didn't like it, but I'm like, nah.
No, that was a place I loved it off on the words.
Yeah. It's really dope. Really dope.
You know what I don't like?
What?
I don't like how uninspired he is.
What do you mean? I feel like he's so inspired now.
Nah, like, I just hear him like, listen, I want to stop making music. I want to go design video games and shit. And it's like, fuck, man.
He wants to really design video games.
Yeah, and it's like, again, I love Trap Soul. You know, I think we're all like, we all know how much impacted our lives and culture, and like, yo, I don't like seeing that. I don't like seeing you being sick of the music. You're supposed to be, I want to see you obsessed with it so that you make something like, not Trap Soul, but something of that value.
Yeah.
What if he's not sick of the music? What if he's sick of the industry?
That's fair. Yeah. And I can't, you know, I don't know him personally, so I can't, you know, that's fair.
Yeah. I think it might be a case of that still, because I feel like he was talking about that before, which is why he took a break.
Oh, yeah?
Was there a break between the last album and
this one? Yeah, there was.
He's talking about Diddy? No. Or just the music industry?
The music industry as a whole. Oh, just kind of being like, he'd rather do his artist shit and, like, design stuff.
So. He saw Diddy's cases, and he's like, I'm out. He's
like,
too much.
No. But, no, that album was honestly good. It's growing on me. I feel like I listened to the whole thing maybe 1.5 times, but I keep going back to the Persuasion record, Calypso, nice. And I think there's like 2 more records on there that I like too. But nah, man, shout out to him for the release. It's nice to, you know, have him back, and I feel like maybe one of the tracks need to do something big in
Is
the
it
summer.
Better than Trap Soul?
Nah. It's not even better than, what's the last one? Sorrows? No. Which one had Sorrows on it? That's the one with the blue cover.
Oh, the anniversary album?
Yes, that one was, bro. He had so many bangers on there. That one's probably my favorite album, I feel like. Even over Trap Soul, maybe.
That's crazy. Yeah. Well, that's fair. But again, that's kind of like him coming back. That was the beginning of his return, so exactly. that's understandable.
Yeah. Well, we got somebody else who dropped too. Some people. This is the Concrete Boys. If you're not familiar, it's Yachty, Caribou, Mad Other Niggas that I don't remember.
Oh.
And this beat switched up too, like, listen.
Dick, and that's exactly where they lost. I just sold a script of perks for double what it cost. I dropped my first song, and the same day the label called. None of these niggas fragile, so I'm letting them down soft. Where your daddy at, bitch? Where your daddy at? I pull up in black truck, GMC, or I go cat. Happily alone because these bitches go out.
Yeah, David School. Somebody's on that, and let me help. Remember when, ASAP crew was doing that?
Yeah.
Was it called Cozy Tapes?
Cozy Tapes, yeah.
Yeah, like that's the kind of energy it was, because it's the whole, like, you know, the whole mob on there, and, you know, just having a good time. So listen to that if you haven't already. It was cool. I think that's it for music. I know I skipped a couple things. I wanted to talk about Miss Harnum Core. If you guys aren't familiar,
I saw that.
The bearded lady.
Oh, yes. Yeah. That's wild.
That is. Listen, that's a topic for another time.
Damn but it.
Her beard's thicker than yours, bro.
Yeah, chill out. That's not, man. No. All right, let's talk about it for a little bit then.
A little bit. Can I grab that drink? Yeah?
Yeah, of course. Okay. Please, yeah. So, yeah.
Got it.
She's a bearded lady. That,
do you want me to open it?
Sure. I have a video of her.
I saw your nails.
Appreciate it.
I got you.
Let me find this video for real quick.
My pleasure.
Yeah, here it is.
Happy a beard, I'm gonna marry you, Hernan. Like, you have a beard. No one's gonna date you, Hernan. You have a beard. No one's gonna be your boyfriend, Hernan. You have a beard. You are not a preference to a lot of men. And then I'll get like really feminine men message me, but that's not who I'm attracted to. Mm-hmm. Hannah, I like really masculine men because I am very soft. I'm so different to what
Duffy side for real.
Like on TV, you know, on TV.
Well, I've never seen you on TV.
Have you not? But no, generally you'll see. Oh, she's strong. She's, you know, what she's talking about is very powerful. Whatever people say, but then at home I'm very quiet. You know, I'm very feminine. I'm very soft. People don't get to see that side of me. You know. But no, it has been difficult. Where I wanted to be married and have kids, I would never be a single mom. That's not what I've ever wanted. I'm gonna marry you.
That's basically the point.
If Beyonce can get cheated on, then
I mean, there it is. Honestly, anyone can get it, fam. What do you think about the video, though?
Yeah, it just honestly, like, it made me think of like the future. It made me think like when you have a kid, like. Can you kind of like shape them into something, or it's becoming like anything goes now. You know what I mean? And it's like, even this is like a new phenomenon to me.
Yeah.
I've never seen like a bearded woman. You know what I mean? Like, I haven't experienced this, but this is becoming more common.
Yeah.
And like, it makes me question like, What authority will I have as a parent when I grow up? Like, what say do I have? And I don't.
Yeah.
You know, that's tricky.
That's a deeper combo for sure. Like, that's definitely for Patreon or some shit. Because, yeah, but no, you're right, though, because anything goes, right? People are just kind of like, my reality should be the reality. And I'm like, I get the sentiment.
That's like the feminism movement. Oh, sorry. I'm not trying to
get... I don't touch those things.
There's the reality we wish, and then there's the actual reality we live in. And and you know what? I commend her for being proud and being who she is, and speaking strong on that, because there's other people with her disorder, or whatever it's called, that can relate to her. I feel like that's a positive on her aspect. But then her, just thinking how like nature works. You're bearded. You're emitting a more masculine energy just by looking at you. So naturally, you're gonna attract feminine men. That's just the way it goes.
Facts.
So it's like, you, if you want a more masculine man, then maybe you need to consider removing that and getting some laser treatment.
Yeah.
Because like what you're asking for, I get like what she's doing. Like, she wants to stand firm in her. But now you're just narrowing the little hole that like that men can come through. Pause. But like, you know, what I mean? Like, you just reduce the amount of people who can come talk to you by like so much. Like, you're gonna find there's somebody for everyone. Mm-hmm. But like, I don't know how like. How likely it is for her to do that. You know what I mean? It's hard.
Yeah, you hit it right on the head. It's really just about that. It's like, you want a specific thing, but you don't want to change for it, because you're like, I shouldn't have to change myself for anything. But it's like, it's
like, it's just like having an understanding of how, like, okay, you have this disorder and you want this. How am I going to get that? Okay, so why are you holding on to your beard? Why? There must be something behind that. Like, why are you holding it onto it so strong? Like, is there a sentimental connection to it?
She might have a brand deal with Andis.
What?
Fucking hell, this guy's dumb. This? This guy's fucking dumb. Andy's in the Clippers for the thing, for your beard.
Oh.
This guy's a dumbass. But man, we're ready for the final segment of the show, which is silly shit. What we do is we normally cheers. Where are the cups at?
Oh shit, did I open this too early?
You're good, you're good.
Oh, okay.
And we're back. Alright, let's take a...
Cheers.
Silly shit. Should have done that. I didn't eat today. Fucking hell. It's delicious, though. Can you put this under the table? Because the niggas are not paying.
Yeah,
they're not paying. Yeah. All right, so first question. Would you rather eat earwax soup or hair sandwich? So soup made up of earwax or a sandwich full of hair?
Hair sandwich. Wait, it's not like...
You don't know where the hair's from, then.
It's my hair.
Oh, is it like...
Ah, it's not your hair.
Is it not head hair?
Which head?
Wow.
This is a tough one.
No, I'm gonna stand on that.
So which one, the sandwich?
Yeah.
I probably do hair too.
Yeah.
No, what's your answer?
Because earwax is like.
I'm starving.
Wait, that's an answer I want to start
that's,
too.
That's not an answer. No. I wanted to say earwax, but that's just the texture, the smell, the taste. Oh God.
Mm-mm.
But then like, the hair sandwich is gonna be stuck in your mouth. Like you're gonna be choking on that. Pause. You know, for like a while. So.
Just chop it up really finely. It's like a salt and pepper.
Yeah. Fuck it. Yeah. I guess we'll do the hair sandwich. So that's number one. Number two is, hold on. Because I'm reading these live for the first time, right? So would you rather do your dog and your dad walk in or do your dad and your dog walk in?
What the fuck? Who is doing these questions?
Yeah, the same nigga that's setting all
fire.
Of
yeah. Excuse me.
So which one, man?
I honestly hate this part of your episode.
I'm not. Wow.
Yo,
I plead the fifth.
Do you know why? I'll tell you why. Because regardless of your answer,
you're fucked.
You're fucked up. See, you pick the dad, and then everyone's gonna think you're something.
Yeah, man.
And then you pick the dog, and everyone thinks you're into
bestiality.
Yeah,
I'm gonna go with the bestiality.
I think that's the only one still.
I hope she's a bitch. That's it.
Guys, dog.
No, you guys gotta answer.
I have to go to the washroom.
No. You can't dunk this one, yo.
Well, I definitely. Oh my god, this is so horrible.
Yep.
Maybe the dog. Unfortunately.
Yeah, it's gotta be the dog, man. Imagine I'm my dad. What the fuck? What do you want, bro? No, 100% the dog. And then, yeah. I don't talk about it anymore. It's fine. The dog. and then the final one we have, would you rather go to federal prison for 1 year or every weekend for 5 years?
Oh, fuck.
So one year straight in prison or every weekend for 5 years, you're going to be in the bin.
Hmm.
You save money. You definitely save money.
1 year.
100%. 1 year?
5 years, you're dragging it out.
5 years, fam, you're saying bare money, like, because going out on the weekend and stuff.
Just, 5 years, you're making different friends and shit. You're fucking.
Got the homies inside.
You're watching people go in and out.
That part.
I'm connected, baby.
That part.
It's me.
Hey, it's a party every time you come over there.
I'm back, baby. Yo,
dude, I got this great opportunity for you to blow up your podcast, but it's got to be on a Saturday. No, I can't.
Saturdays. You're not getting locked up, fam. You know my situation.
I'd probably choose 5 years.
5 years?
Wow. Yeah.
Hold up, why?
Why? Because I can come in and out, make connections, get things moving if I have to.
There's all the bunker right
then,
here, bro.
And then when I come back, like, it's gonna be like a party. Hey, what's going on, family?
Exactly.
You know what I mean? Good vibes.
Yeah, it's like you're back outside for a while.
For a couple days. And I'm saving on the weekends.
Exactly.
That's fair.
Yeah.
That's fair.
A whole year.
That's fucked up. That's how fucked up our society is, that you consider saving money on the weekends.
And hey, they just said New York and Miami is more affordable to live in than in Toronto.
Yeah, so. I heard that.
Here, I hate it here.
That's what it is.
I'm gonna leave here soon, bro.
Me too.
All of us in this room.
Let's go. Yeah. Where are we going to?
Miami.
Honestly,
I might do Montreal still.
What? Why are you staying in Canada?
Wait, it was Two-Face. The fuck, nigga? Like, yo, damn. Montreal is like baby Toronto.
I'm going to Texas.
Yes.
Texas might be the spot. But
I'm
also,
coming to your spot.
Niggas have it on them.
I know.
That's
and
good.
I can't smoke weed.
All right. Niggas get pissed
off. You can't smoke weed in Texas?
Yeah.
Wait, what?
How crazy is that?
We can't get abortions
either.
Well,
that's okay. You can't get abortion. That's
well,
okay.
Listen, I think people smoke weed, but it is illegal, so you could actually get jailed.
Yeah,
for
yeah
and
you
stuff.
Can actually get jail.
Same for abobos. So, I don't think I want to go there still. Why do you want to get quiet, then? I said same for abortions. They're not legal in Texas.
That's okay. I'm done anyways.
Vibes? Huh? I'm pro-choice, so. So am I.
I have the green card. I'll come down to Toronto.
Oh, that's fire.
Right?
Yeah, but honestly, guys, thank you for coming on. It's been
thank you for having us.
I'll return on my podcast.
Yo, and hold on before we get off. I love giving you love and like yo, 2024, like straight up, you've been fucking snapping.
Thank you.
Yo,
hey.
Every guest, every episode. You know, it's really hard to go through your personal life. and you know what I mean, and do this podcast and edit, post, release, record. You're working on this episode, you're working on next episode, wow, you're working on the previous episode, you're doing all these things. So like, yo, I want to give you your flowers, but like, you're snapping.
Thank
and
you,
keep bro. It going for the
thank
rest
you,
of year.
That's
thank
amazing.
You,
thank I'm you, gonna bro. Clap for that.
Thank you,
that's some hard work. That's some hard work. Honestly, that's dedication.
He's working too, like going crazy, you know, with his show.
Shout out Bigger Dreams, shout out Tranny. Shout out Drew.
I need a return episode, bro. I need a return episode. We got some shit to talk about.
Bro, you are the second most viewed episode on our channel. We're waiting for the right time to bring you back. You're one of two guests coming back, I told you.
Of course.
That's sick.
But yeah, man, like I always... Oh, wait, hold on. You guys have anything to plug? Your all social media is going to be
social
in the bio
media.
And stuff.
You go first.
All right. Well, you guys can follow me at The Peruvian Goddess.
That's
on Instagram,
handle.
Right? And we also make grills at GTA Grills. And we made Annalise Grills. Yeah.
You make me a grill?
Yeah, for sure. We'll connect.
I'm down.
Right. I'm connected to a jeweler. Shout out Jay Diamond, Toronto.
Hey, Jay Diamond.
Shout out Diamond Smile, Teeth Whitening.
Shout out Bigger Dreams Podcast. Shout out Tarani. Mm-hmm. Shout out Drew. Shout out Infamous Abstract. And we're here. We're building.
Yeah, man. Shout out, bro. Tarani, you need an episode, bro. Soon. Very quick soon. But no, man, like I always say, you guys could have been anywhere in the world, but instead you guys decided to be here watching us or listening to us, which for that, I'm super duper grateful. So thank you. And we'll be back again in 2 weeks. But yeah, boom.
Yay! Wow, that's so.